Up next on Line TV, we have Alexia Farron with a story about Enquire, Charity Sanders with a brand new line of the week,
and me, Landon Marie, with your weather updates. All that and more at Line TV starts now.
Revolution Day, Cersei. I'm Andrew Tyler.
And I'm Paige Renounce. Let's take a look at our school announcements.
Do you want to join the student council? In order to run for office, you must complete the 2022-2023 intent to run for council by tomorrow. Any further questions? Email Ms. Seidelman.
Beta Club had a meeting this morning in the cafeteria. Seniors received their Beta Honor Cords at this meeting.
There will be an upcoming informational meeting for any student entering grades 9 through 12 who are interested in trying out for the 2022-2023 SHS tennis team. That meeting will take place Monday, April 25th at 4 o'clock in the SHS cafeteria.
Don't forget, this coming Saturday is prom. Only juniors and seniors will be eligible for game prizes. These will be awarded at the end of the evening. Ticket sales will be on sale until Thursday, April 21st. You may also purchase your ticket at the door on prom night. Tickets are non-refundable and non-transferable. This applies to purchased tickets as well as tickets earned by prom points. Also, please check on the dress code.
This is a reminder that graduation caps and gowns are not allowed to be decorated and or altered in any way. Students will not be allowed to walk in graduation ceremonies if they have decorated and or altered their caps and or gowns.
Senior walkthrough for the graduating class of 2022 will be held April 22nd. Seniors will start at 9:15 Searcy High School, 9:45 Southwest Middle School, 10:15 Mark Ray Elementary, 10:35 Alf Junior High, 11 o'clock Sydney Diener, 11:45 Westside Elementary.
Hey Paige, it looks like the choir got an Enquire group together this year. I cannot wait to see what this group is about.
Well, wait no more. Lexi has a story for us just about that.
Here at Searcy High School, there are many different groups within our choir. One that really stands out from the rest is Enquire. With a distinct way of singing and an upcoming performance featuring a song from a popular film, this group has intrigued many.
A smaller group of people, it was more of kind of like an intimate setting of choir, and you get to know people better.
I feel like other choir groups are more focused on learning theory and solfege and like learning skills. Enquire is just about like performing.
We have a lot of arrangements of like pop songs, and we'll take a cappella versions of that. When everybody's together, it kind of creates, like it kind of sounds like there's instruments with it, especially since sometimes we have a beatboxer.
With a special performance coming up, a beatboxer had to be brought in to elevate the performance.
I talked to Ms. Thomas and she said she needed a beatboxer for the concert, and since the beatboxers in choir couldn't do it, she went ahead and asked me if I could do it.
Enquire members are especially excited for their upcoming song from a popular film.
We're all really excited because we're singing a song from Pitch Perfect, and me and all of my friends love Pitch Perfect. It's a really cool song and there's a lot of movement in our choreography that we're doing for it, and we're excited to show it to people.
With a concert this month, members hope to see positive results.
Everybody puts in a lot of work and we work really hard on getting it like perfect.
Everybody do well, people enjoy it, show up, show out kind of thing.
With no instruments and beatboxing, Enquire is a group that we hope to see make waves here at Searcy High School. Their upcoming performance is on Thursday, April 28th. We hope to see many of you there. Back to the news desk.
Thanks, Lexi. I really enjoy choir.
I did too, but now I believe it's time to take a look at national news.
Days after the subway shooting in Brooklyn, New York City, Mayor Eric Adams told ABC This Week anchor George Stephanopoulos that the recent increase in crime extends beyond his city, calling it a national issue.
Shawnee State University in Ohio has reached a settlement with a professor whom it punished for refusing to use a transgender student's preferred pronouns. According to a news report, the university will pay philosophy professor Nick Merriweather $400,000 in damages and attorney fees, and will rescind a written warning issued to Merriweather in June 2018 in response to a biological male student's complaint that the professor refused to use female pronouns for him.
Two teenagers were killed and at least eight were wounded when a barrage of 50 gunshots broke out early Sunday in a Pittsburgh Airbnb rental house where police said roughly 200 people were having a party. Some escaped the gunfire by jumping out of windows. The shooting marked the third time in 9 days that gunfire erupted during parties being held at Airbnb rentals.
As depressing as that is, I hear we'll be seeing more of that beautiful sun.
For that, we'll have to turn to our friend Landon Marino. How's this week looking, Landon?
Thanks, guys. Today, our high is 67, cloudy, rains at 59%, winds going south-southeast at 17 miles per hour, humidity at 70%, and your sun will rise at 6:28 a.m. On to tonight. Tonight, our low is 67, cloudy skies, 50% chance of rain, winds going south at 13 miles per hour, humidity at 80%, and your sun will set at 7:43 p.m. onto our almanac. Our last 7 days' temperatures, high has been 74, low has been 51, a monthly average of precipitation is 5.42 inches, and month of date is 4.92 inches onto our forecast. Thursday is scattered thunderstorms, 78 as your high, 62 as your low with a 38% chance of rain. Friday is mostly cloudy, 81 as your high, 63 as your low with a 7% chance of rain. Saturday is partly cloudy, 81 as your high, 64 as your low with a 5% chance of rain. Sunday is partly cloudy, 81 as your high, 64 as your low and 23% chance of rain. And on Monday, we have scattered thunderstorms with 72 as your high, 52 as your low with a 52% chance of rain. Looks like we still have those April showers. Now back to the news desk.
Well, you know what they say about Arkansas weather.
You're not wrong. But all this talking has got me starving. What's for lunch, Paige?
Today we'll be having spaghetti and meatballs, dinner roll, baby carrots, baked beans, pineapple tidbits, cup, grapes, cupcakes, and milk variety.
Sounds delicious.
You know, I just got to thinking, I have not seen the new episode of Two Chicks and a Flick.
Well, you're in luck, because here's the latest episode of Two Chicks and a Flick.
This is Emily Tyler.
And Paige Reynolds.
Here to bring you a...
Oh, just get on with it already.
You're boring.
We're here to bring you a brand new episode of...
Two Chicks and a Flick.
First up, we have two trivia questions that need to be answered.
The first one is, in The Wizard of Oz 1939, what was used to simulate snow in the poppy scene?
And that answer was, drum roll please.
Asbestos.
Congratulations if you got that answer. Our next trivia question is, in Ghostbusters, what prompts Dr. Peter Venkman to say,
well, there's something you don't see every day.
The answer is, Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
I think it's time to talk about movies. That's what we all came here for.
Yeah, first up we have Turning Red, which just came out on Disney Plus not too long ago.
Turning Red is a family comedy movie about a teenage girl named Mei Li, who is torn between being the perfect daughter for her mother and her chaotic youth. But when her emotions get a little out of hand, she discovers that life can get a lot more messy.
All about that hustle, am I right?
I might have to watch this movie when I have a little more time in my life.
Emily, what can you tell me about the movie Marry Me? This is the first time I've heard about it.
Well, Marry Me stars Jennifer Lopez and Owen Wilson, and it came out in February. Right before Kat Valdez, pop superstar, is about to go on stage, she learns that her fiancé cheated on her, which leads her to have a meltdown in front of her loyal fans. She then locks eyes with a stranger in the crowd and decides to marry him, which throws her life into chaos as others conspire to pull them apart. The two newlyweds are still deciding if two people from completely different worlds can find true love.
Is this smart?
I think we left smart 6 weeks ago.
Wow, I can't wait to watch it.
I can't believe you haven't already. Have you at least heard of Obi-Wan Kenobi?
Yeah, I can't wait to watch it over summer. Obi-Wan Kenobi is a new TV show, and the first episode airs on May 25th. It stars Hayden Christensen, Ewan McGregor, and Rupert Friend. Obi-Wan Kenobi Jedi Master deals with the aftermath of his greatest defeat, the downfall of his ex-friend and apprentice, Anakin Skywalker, turning to the dark side and becoming Lord Darth Vader.
That reminds me of this coffee place I tried over spring break, the Dark Side Coffee Company. The coffee was amazing.
That does seem pretty cool, but I think it's time for a trivia question.
Yeah, I think you're right. Which bounty hunter in The Empire Strikes Back is wearing an old costume from a Doctor Who episode?
See that answer in the next episode.
Paige, I think our time is up.
I was just about to ask.
Bye! Bye.
I am so excited for all those movies to come out.
I am too. But don't you think we could use a few sports updates?
Most definitely. So here's Jacob Shoey with the latest.
Welcome back, Searcy High. Let's hit these week sports updates before going into this Wednesday morning. In local sports, the Searcy Lions baseball team had a game last Friday against the Cabot Panthers. The Lions would lose by just a hair, losing 10-11. Their next game will be this Thursday when they hit the road to take on the Sylvan Hill Bears. The Searcy Lions track team had a meet last week in Bebu where we would see competitors Mason Skiba placed first in the 1600 meters finals, Robert Armitage placing first in high jump, and Tamara Hogan placing second in the 100 meter dash. The Lions' next meet will be this Friday in Heber Springs. The Searcy Lions esports team will be starting playoffs this week where we'll see Smash Bros. Team go into it with the number one seed and the Mario Kart team going into it with the number two seed. Many of these games will be starting at 4 o'clock and will be streamed on twitch.tv/CerseiEsports. In national sports, the St. Louis Blues has gone on one of the hottest streaks in recent time where they have won 10 games in a row to clinch a playoff spot and a chance to win the Stanley Cup. They have also, during this hot streak, have scored at least 3 points in each of their last 12 games, second most of all time behind the 1996 Pittsburgh Penguins. Expect this St. Louis Blues team to be making some noise once playoff starts. In the MLB, the players of the week have been announced, with Chicago Cubs recently acquired outfielder Seiya Suzuki winning it in the National League, where last week he had a batting average of .412, 3 homers, 2 doubles, and 5 RBIs, while all-star third baseman for the Cleveland Guardians, Jose Ramirez, won it in the American League, where he had a batting average of .478, 2 home runs, 11 RBIs, and an OPS of 1.432. Expect many great things from these players heading into the rest of this long and exciting MLB season. The first round of NBA playoffs are underway with 3 games taking place on Monday, including the 76ers beating the Raptors 112-97, Mavericks beating the Jazz 110-104, and the Warriors beating the Nuggets 126-106. Well, Searcy, that's all the sports updates I have for you this week. I hope everyone has a great rest of their Wednesday. Now back to the news desk with Paige and Andrew.
Thanks for the sports updates, Jacob.
I think we are missing something.
No, Paige, you're missing something. I, on the other hand, haven't forgotten about Charity's new line of the week.
My apologies. Let's see who is the newest line of the week.
Welcome back, Searcy High, to another episode of Line of the Week. I'm Charity Sanders, and this week's line is sophomore soccer player Liam Wessel. Why did you decide to join soccer?
I've played soccer in Germany since I was little, so I just decided to keep it going here.
Why?
Because I like the sport. It's my favorite sport. It's my passion.
Okay. What aspect of training or coaching has helped you improve as a team player?
The coaching in all has helped me a lot, because the coach trains us hard, trains us right, makes sure we are a good team player, and does the right drills to help us improve.
Okay. What is your goal for the remainder of the season?
I think my goal and the goal of the whole team is to win state this year.
How would you improve that?
I think we just need to stay focused. We need to, in games, we need to stay concentrated. Even if we're behind by 1 point, we just need to keep it going.
Okay. What is your favorite memory of soccer this season and why?
My favorite memory was our 5-4 victory against Jonesboro. It was a very tough game. It was leading everything, far away game, and we haven't beat them in quite a long time, and that was our first time beating them.
Okay, tell me a little more about that.
It was at the beginning of the season, was our first conference game, and we went there. JV played, the girls played, then it started sleeting. It was very cold, and they ended up having two red cards, so we kept pushing and scored our goals.
Okay. What will you miss when you leave back to Germany?
Oh, I definitely miss the whole soccer team, the long bus rides and the away games.
Why?
Because it's just fun hanging out with all your friends, playing soccer. That's just what makes us a team.
Okay. That's all I have for you today, Cersei. I'm yours truly, Charity Sanders. Now back to the news desk.
Thanks, Charity. Our newest line of the week sure is pretty great.
Well, that's all the time we have for today, Cersei.
But be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Cersei High Lion TV.
And to follow us on Twitter at Lion TV, Instagram at Cersei Lion TV, and on Facebook at Cersei High Lion TV. Signing off, I'm Paige Reynolds.
And for the last time ever, I'm Andrew Touchdown Tyler. Keep it real, Cersei.